Hey everybody, how's it? All right, arch enemy, the world is yours. Yesterday, nice mellow start to my week. Mark Bouchard and also the Smashing Pumpkins. And it looks like I'm gonna be getting back into some metal here based on the thumbnail here. So I wanna thank all you guys for your comments, for hanging in there. My God, I'm just rolling on what, almost 5 months of doing this. It's been really fun. I've been a little ahead of myself. Two, sometimes three videos a day. I mean, I say to myself, geez, I need to get a job. I go, oh, wait a minute. I'm a grandfather and a husband and a father, yeah, and a job and a composer. And I got a job. I just do this because I just love to do this. If you've never been here and listened to any of my videos, this is not a theoretical breakdown, though sometimes I do jump into a little bit of it. This is for you, the pure listener. I just try to bring out some cool things from my point of view, an old composer, hence the Decomposer Lounge, to see if I can't bring another level of awareness to your favorite song. I want to thank you guys for your support. A lot of you know that when I do these videos, if you see commercials, it's not monetized for me or the channel. It's copyright claim for them. So if you'd like to support me in this channel, if you buy me a cup of coffee, super cool beans, a link for all of their music, their Spotify, their merch, the band merch, Arch Enemy, will also be down below. And a link for the headsets, too, will be down below. All right, let's do this. Arch Enemy, the world is yours. All right. You know what, the physical stamina that it must take to do this, I mean, in all of my years of composition, I've never been asked from any client, director, producer, anything that I work for, publisher, to actually do any of this style of music. And I mean, I can play guitar and I've played drums and bass and keyboards and stuff. But a lot of these musicians, with their intense stamina of musicianship, is unbelievable. What does it take? I mean, I'm sure that the spring set for the kick and stuff, you know, there's a lot of great equipment out there to make life a lot easier. But the double kick thing, then they when they just machine gun like that, as well as everything else that's going on right there, it's just absolutely mental. I love the tone of the drums on this. This is a great EQ and a great setting in the mix and stuff. And like I've always said before, the drums are usually the ones that set the depth and the dynamics and engineering for width in your headsets, you know, left to right. You get the ambiance of a complete effect of stereo. However, when you have really super great engineering and technical dynamics on that aspect, you take a guitar sound and split it left, hard, right, you know, like it is, that also kind of like gives an even more wider dynamic to that sound. I see two guitar players there, but I also seem to hear when that really nice melody came in that the guitar player was playing. I believe that's the hook. Excuse me. It sounded like there was something behind it during that crunch period. I don't know if it was a keyboard. I don't see a keyboard player in this video, but it sounded like a little bit of a different sound. And then this young lady here, this performer here. I'm now used to not being shocked when I hear growling by young performers or young ladies. As you guys know, I've gone through the rinse cycle with Ginger and some other bands and stuff like that. But this particular one, her performance, I actually can understand some of the words. I'm not saying that to besmirch any of the other performers, but as your old Decomposer listening, you know, I have a lot of times. There's times where I'm trying to listen to the performance, but I can't pick up any words whatsoever on some of them. And this one I can. And so I don't know if that's a lesser, more technique, or if it's a principle that she focuses on in her performance that, you know, let's get some of those words to get across. Because you know me, when I do my first time listens and stuff, I'm not listening to words. So it really doesn't matter anyhow. But I mean, because I'm listening to the performer and the lead singer as an instrument and stuff. So let's keep this going. All right. Stop real quick. Okay, so I thought at first, and when I heard the hook at first, remember you heard me say, sounded like something else was behind it. It sounds more like it's just, you know, just a one guitar layer on top of the, I think I see two guitar players here. So there is like an octave of that melody. Da, 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 da. There's the octave there, and still there's a crunch below it. So I just wanted to clarify that, okay, that wasn't keys or anything like that, but just wanted to let you, whatever. Like that. Okay, there are keys in here, obviously. Maybe not in the area that I thought, but that was a pleasant surprise. I loved how they did halftime in that, whether you drop down to that beat where you could just really get into a really deep, heavy vibe. And so, I mean, they're repeating the phrase from previous, but taking it down into half beat actually makes it a little more heavier, a little more punch in the gut kind of vibe. It's not that the super fast performance of the musicians isn't already, I mean, we've set ourselves up on this really super energetic journey with this and their musicianship and the way they're playing and the way she's performing, but dropping into that halftime did give it that little extra, like, dark, for me, a little bit more of a darker, heavier, grittier kind of vibe to it. Then the keys. All right, we got the keys. I just heard that piano and pad, so I don't know, since I've never heard of the band, and I don't know anything about the musicians and the members of the musicians. I don't know if that was just an elected overdub that they wanted to do in their composition, or there is somebody back there that's actually part of the band. I can't imagine, excuse me, that at least if they were to go on tour or something like that, they'd hire a keyboard player if there isn't one. But you guys tell me that, because that's where I learn the most, is when you, the fan, tell me about, you know, your favorite artists and acts and stuff. So let's go back. Listen a little more. I really like the melody these guys had arranged there through that, you know, through their chorus, if you would. It's a very memorable hook, and one that for me is very unique for this type of powered, you know, death metal-y, death metal kind of vibe here. It's a what I would call a blooming melody. You know, it kind of takes you and lifts you and lifts you and lifts you. You know, da 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 da. It kind of is a lifting melody and stuff. And I like how that phrase through this whole, you know, 5 minutes worth of music. I like how that phrase was so tastefully put in these, you know, part of the hook, it sounded like. But it's enough that at least it gave me a melodic hook to hang on to. And by the time it got to the second time, it was well enough written that I already was like, dun, 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 you know, already in my head, I was already, had that melody already hooked in me, hence the hook in the chorus. Excuse me. Again, her voice, something that I noticed in the engineering, there's some really unique layering and techniques going on in the engineering of her voice in the hook. You know, with some doubling and stuff, and I did hear some really super rich hard left right split delayed effect on some of her passes in her melody. I mean, in the hook. I mean, it's very back in there. It's definitely not something that's in your face, but you know, believe it or not, amongst all the heaviness in the hook, I can hear a really super cool wide delay that happens just every now and then. It's just, you know. And then the other thing, I don't know if this is pre or post. I'm going to lay my wisdom on the fact that I think it was post, but there was a nice little turnaround that also happened with the guitar where everything was out, and this, I thought for seconds it was a synth sequence that was coming in and out, and it came in again, and boom, and all of a sudden it was a guitar. That was really super cool engineering. That was a really super cool choice in production. Anyhow, thank you guys. This is my first journey with Arch Enemy. Please let me know of any other songs from Arch Enemy you want me to do, or any bands in the same kind of genre you want me to check out. Once again, I appreciate you hanging out. I appreciate the support. God, I'm just having a blast doing this. And thanks to you guys, I really appreciate your time and energy for coming here on the channel and hanging out and all your opinions and sharing this journey with me. All right, guys, take it easy. I got another one coming later on today. So, sun's about to come up. I'm going to do my walk. And that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. All right. Yeah! All right.